Hi everyone. Waiting for some more people to come up. I am Pooja Pandit from Mumbai, and I'll be showing two recipes today. Hi. Just waiting for some more people to come. Yeah. Like within 2 minutes we'll start. Hello Manish ji, hi Jasmine ji, hi Sneha. Okay, so I'll start an introduction. I'm Pooja Pandit from Mumbai, Maharashtra, and I'll be showing two recipes today. One is Maharashtrian Masale Baath, and this is a no onion, no garlic recipe, which is made with a specific masala called Goda Masala. And the other recipe is a Mexican burger for which I have made some pre-preparations. Okay, so shall we start now? Hello. Hi. Yeah, I think there are quite a few people already online, so we can start with looking at the ingredients of the first recipe, that is the Maharashtrian Masale Baath. Okay, here are the ingredients. This is the rice which I had soaked, basmati rice which I had soaked in water. This is 1 1/4 cup of rice. I had soaked it in sufficient water for like 1 1/2 hour. Okay, now I have drained it totally. And for tempering, we'll be using oil and ghee. Right, then we have mustard seeds, cloves, cinnamon and bay leaves, turmeric. We have some cauliflower and some chopped brinjals. This is the brinjal I'm using. Okay. And the rest of the spices and the vegetables I'll be showing later, because first we have to start with cooking the brinjals and the cauliflower for 5 minutes. Yeah, so let me start here. First we'll start with heating the pan. Now I'll add some oil. This recipe is already on Cookpad, Maharashtrian Masale Bhat, on the English recipes. I'm not adding too much oil right now because I'll be adding some homemade ghee over here. And as we don't have any onion and garlic to saute, this much oil is enough at the moment. Yeah, so while it heats up, I'll transfer all the tempering ingredients. And some asafoetida, that is hing. Yeah, so this is rai, mustard seeds, long dalchini, clove, cinnamon or tejpan, bay leaves. This is turmeric, haldi, or ye hai hing. First I'll add this mustard seeds. You know, when the mustard seeds crackle, we get to know that the oil has heated enough. And then we can carry on with the rest of the ingredients. Here I have boiled double water. That is, if the rice was 1 1/4 cup water rice, I have taken 2 1/2 cups water and I have just boiled it hot enough so that when we add it to the rice, it starts cooking immediately. Now the mustard seeds are crackling. Once all the mustard seeds crackle, only then we should start adding the rest of the tempering ingredients. See, You can hear this. So now I'm adding the cloves, the cinnamon, okay, and here I'm putting the hing, that is the asafoetida. I'll reduce the flame at this stage so that the turmeric doesn't burn, and I'm adding the turmeric powder also. Just half or 3/4 teaspoon. Now I'll add the cauliflower and I'll increase the temperature, the heat, okay? And I'll saute the cauliflower. Now I'll add these chopped brinjals which I had kept in water for about 5 minutes. Saute this very well and let the temperature of the vegetables also increase. So keep sauteing for about a minute or so. Anybody who has joined late, I am making Maharashtrian Masale Baath. I am from Mumbai. And this rice actually doesn't take too much time to cook. Okay, now that we have added these vegetables, we will cover this and let this cook for on medium flame for about 4 to 5 minutes. By the time we can carry on with the rest of the ingredients. So next, after 4 minutes, I'll be adding this chopped capsicum, then chopped carrots, even ivy gourd, that is Stanley, is added to this rice if you wish. These are green peas. Then here I have coriander powder and cumin powder, dhania jeera powder. Here I have some Kashmiri powder, red chili, and some spicy red chili powder. Please adjust as per your taste. And this is the goda masala. Even though it is said goda masala, and god in Marathi is like sweet, but this is nothing sweet. It has a nutty flavor and it is very unique masala. Okay, you can get it in stores. I am using a homemade one over here. And for garnishing, in the end we have this fresh grated coconut and some coriander leaves. And main garnishing ingredient is some homemade ghee, because this rice should have some homemade ghee in it. Only then it tastes really very good. Okay, and Maharashtrian Masale Baath. So what is Baath? So this is raw rice. Jo aap log chawal kehte hai, Marathi mein ise tandoor kehte hai. And when the rice is cooked, in Marathi it is called Baath. Maharashtra, in Maharashtra people are speaking Marathi. That's why the name of the recipe is Masale Baath. Okay, cooked rice with some masalas, that is some specific spices, especially this one which is goda masala. I have prepared at home. You can get it in the stores also. Yeah, and you can use spices, adjust according to your taste, the chili powder and some other vegetables you want to use. You can also use like tendli. Yeah, we will check over here now. See, the vegetables are cooking. As these vegetables take a bit longer to cook, we'll be cooking for a little extra time, and we'll be adding some salt to taste in the process. Okay, so let's get back to sauteing this. Now, as I am showing two recipes today and that too within a stipulated time, okay, I'll be cooking this for maybe a minute or two shorter, because along with the rice they will get cooked. Yeah, you can cook a little more if you wish to. I have some time limitations today. Okay, now along with this, first I will add the green bell peppers, that is the capsicum and the carrots. I'll again increase the flame to high, because we need to bring all the vegetables at equal temperature right now. Now I'll be adding the green peas. Saute all the vegetables on high flame. The green peas and carrots don't need to be cooked previously. Okay,
they cook along with the rice very easily. Now I'll add the red chili powder, the coriander cumin powder, and this is the goda masala, which you should adjust as per taste. I'm adding like almost 3 teaspoons over here for 1 1/4 cup of basmati rice. The rice actually used here is Ambe Mohar variety, but that is not available outside Maharashtra maybe. And basmati also goes very well over here. That's why I'm using basmati rice, and that's why I'm using double water. In the recipe on Cookpad, I have written Ambe Mohar. If you get that, you can use that. That is an aromatic rice variety from Maharashtra. Next, I'll be adding this soaked and drained rice. Okay. Now, while I mix this, I'll add in some homemade ghee. That's the reason I added little less oil in the beginning. This will again go for garnishing also. When you're serving this rice, you have to top it with some melted or ghee, okay, and some coriander leaves, and main ingredients is a fresh grated coconut. Now we are sauteing the rice lightly, and let's bring it to the temperature along with the vegetables, so that when we add in the hot water, the rice will get cooked very nicely. And I am adding some salt to taste. So here you will see, you can see how the bubbles are coming up immediately because the temperature of the water and the rice has matched. Okay, so this gives you a very nice fluffy rice in the end. And this is not a very spicy rice preparation, okay? It is a less spicy one. So if you like spicy food, you can always increase. And to check whether your salt is proper, you know, what you have to do that at this stage itself, just take a little taste. Yeah, mine is alright because the water should be just 1% salty. If it is 1% salty, then when the rice fluffs up and cooks, it will be proper, like the salt will be exact, you know. Okay, so now I will cover this with a lid, but I'll keep a gap. I want the water to evaporate a bit. And then I'll just shift this vessel from here. Yeah. And we'll shift another stove. You can see here. Give it a stir. Let the water evaporate, you know, up to half. I have added 1 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, dhania powder, and 3-4 teaspoon of cumin, that is jeera powder, and goda masala, as I said, I have added 3 teaspoons, yeah, and some ghee. Now you can see the water is almost evaporating. I have put it on complete low heat and I'm putting the lid. Now we'll allow this to cook and we'll start with the Mexican burger. By that time the rice will cook up. Okay, so here I have used this rajma, that is red beans, which I soaked overnight. 1 cup you can soak. Yeah, and the next morning drain them, rinse them well, and in about 3 1/2 cups or 3 cups of water, you can cook them for 8 whistles or 10 whistles in a pressure pan. I have boiled some sweet corn, and this is sweet potatoes which I had boiled. Now this rajma, when the pressure releases, please drain it and cool it completely. Then you have to grind it in a mixer coarsely, grate the boiled potatoes and keep the corn intact. Again, you can see these breadcrumbs, these are the ready-made ones. But for adding in this, what I did,
is I use fresh brown bread slices and I put them in a mixer. I made some small pieces and I took fresh brown bread crumbs and that I added to this mixture. So when this was like 2.5 cups, I added about 3/4 to 1 cup of boiled potato, 1 cup of fresh bread crumbs, then 1 cup of this boiled sweet corn, because when you're biting into, these are the ingredients for the patty which I have pre-prepared. So when you're biting into it, this you shouldn't grind, okay? Just grind the rajma. Now here I have added some garlic powder and smoked paprika and red chili powder. But for forming the patty, you can always use some garlic paste, or along with this, the rajma, you can grind some garlic cloves and add red chili according to your taste and some coriander leaves. Okay, then you will get this type of a dough. Mix all together and form such patties. Next, what you have to do is, this is the rice flour slurry I have prepared. I have used 1/4 cup of rice flour and about 1/2 cup of water. See, not very thick. Make it like this, a bit thin, okay? And these are store-bought breadcrumbs. You can use fresh breadcrumbs. These are for coating. Now this patty, you have to dip into this slurry. Drain and you have to coat with these breadcrumbs, and this is how it looks. Refrigerate for 15 minutes to 30 minutes so it sets well, right? And then for the burger, here I have mixed mayonnaise and red chili sauce. This is not sweet red chili sauce. I have used 1/2 and 1/2 of both. You can increase or decrease the red chili sauce. Again, these are the jalapeno poppers which is used in Mexican food a lot, okay? So this you can finely chop, and if you don't have these, you can always use green chilies which we get, okay, and chop them finely. Now this is the salsa. This will all go into the burger. For the salsa, like I have used red, green, yellow, all 3 bell peppers. You can use only green if you want. If you have 1 cup of those mixed bell peppers, I have used 1 cup of tomato, chopped tomatoes, and 3/4 cup of chopped onions. To that you add oregano or mixed herbs as per your choice, then some salt to taste and some chopped coriander leaves. And here is the guacamole which we make using avocado, okay? You have to take a ripe avocado, and if you get a raw avocado, the trick is to keep it in a brown paper bag with a ripe banana, and when it gets dark brown and a little soft, then you will get to know it has ripened, okay? Peel it, de-seed it. You have got a big seed inside, so just smash it with a fork. And to it, what you have to add is like one medium avocado will give you like 1 1/4 cup of mash, avocado mash. To that you add 1/4 cup of chopped onions, then 2 tablespoons of chopped coriander leaves, then 1 finely grated garlic clove, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, salt to taste, and some red chili flakes. Now what I always do is I add some mango to it. So I have added some chopped mango to this. If you have frozen mango puree, you can add little of that, not too much. If you're making for one avocado, you can add just maybe like 1 or 2 tablespoons only, not much. And these are again the iceberg lettuce which we love. You can add any other lettuce. Secondly, if you don't have avocado and you don't get you think it's very costly, there's another option. Take some hung curd. Yeah, to hung curd you add little cumin, salt, then this grated garlic and some finely chopped carrots and cabbage and some onions. And instead of guacamole, you can use that dip also for this Mexican burger. Alright, and in this, we add the red chili flakes. And for the salsa, you use the jalapeno peppers. That is as per your choice. You can use any other red chili or green chilies also. Okay, so here that is the dough for the burger. This is the patty which I'll be frying to show to you all. And this is the one we should be dipped in this rice slurry. For anybody who has joined late, I'm showing it again. Okay, and then in the breadcrumbs. And please refrigerate. And keep it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. So if you have a party or anything, everything can be pre-prepared also.
Now I'll be placing this griddle over here. Okay. I've got an iron griddle.
Till that we can check this rice. I'll be adding some oil so that we can fry the patty for the burger over here. Yeah. And if you wish, in the meantime, you can add a little more ghee because the rice soaks it all up. That is as per your choice. Here you can see the oil is already heated up. Okay. Now we'll be adding this patty. When you release the patty in the oil should be hot. Okay, completely hot. Now let's check from the bottom because it gets cooked very fast. It still some time. This doesn't take long if you have already pre-prepared your patties, you know. You can even cook the rajma, that is the red beans, the previous night if you are making in the morning. And if you are making in the evening for parties, you can cook them in the morning itself and refrigerate the dough or these patties or even the rajma. So here now we have turned, you can see it has turned completely crispy. Okay, now we after this we have to just assemble the burger. That won't take much time. Here you can see I have brought these nachos because in Mumbai where you're getting Mexican burgers, you know, they put some nachos also inside the burger and it gives a good taste. Yeah, now this is done and we'll drain it onto an absorbent paper which I've already kept to here. Now we'll start with assembling the burger. Yeah. First, I'll be using this dip, the mayonnaise and the red chili sauce which I had mixed together. Please apply quite a good quantity because the beans and the potato burger actually they don't have any sweet taste to it, only the little sweet corn that we have added. So all these things give it a little moisture and some nice taste. Next I'll be placing this iceberg lettuce. Okay. Now here I am again adding the salsa. with 3 colored bell peppers, red, green and yellow, chopped tomatoes, onions, some coriander, chopped jalapeno green chilies, salt to taste, and some mixed herbs. I always have pizza seasoning at home, which we like. So we use that. You can use oregano. Next, we'll be placing this hot patty on top. And I have a cheese slice over here. These have really become very thin nowadays. Difficult to manage. Yeah, this will melt on the hot top, on top of the hot patty. Now what we'll do, this is our mango guacamole. You can add as much quantity as you like, or as I had told you, you can even use that hunkered dip. You can prepare if you don't want to buy avocado, that will also go well with this. And I was thinking of one thing, that now mangoes, I got Dashahari mango. If you don't get, I was thinking that even aloo bukhara, that is plums will go nice with this. We'll place these nachos like this on top. How much you want, that quantity. And then, so this is your burger. This is your Mexican burger. You can serve it along with some extra salsa or even some French fries, potato wedges, and some extra mayo and chili dip. Now we have to check our rice also over here. Let's wait a minute. It has got a lovely color because of the Kashmiri red chili powder actually, which I've used. And recently I got an organic one, which is giving a lovely color and very less spiciness. Otherwise, this is not at all a spicy rice preparation. Okay, so we can see that this is done. And actually now we are short of time. Otherwise, you keep it with the lid on for some more time, like 15-20 minutes. The rice puffs up a lot in that time. But after you have switched off the flame, yeah, just keep it covered for some more time. Yeah, the rice has cooked very nicely. And all the spices and the salt has been perfect over here. Now I'll switch off this flame. Okay, and I will serve it. Yo, I got this serving plate. Serve this rice. Maharashtrian Masale Baath. Masale Baath means cooked rice using goda masala. In Maharashtra, not all people use goda masala. It is used by specific community. And they use it in dals and some vegetable preparations with some added jaggery, that is good. Okay. So we have got all the vegetables. Right. Now keep this covered, you know, actually after cooking, after switching off the flame, you keep it covered. Yeah. Now first we will add some ghee to it, which you can mix while you're eating. You need some melted ghee. I'm adding this. And please, this step is very important because it gives a very, very beautiful taste. Okay, delicious taste. You need ghee. And this, another thing is very important, the freshly grated coconut. This sweetness and the taste of ghee goes very well with the nutty flavor of this specific goda masala, which is not sweet, but it is not at all like garam masala. That masala too does not have any onion or garlic, but it does have some dry grated coconut, some naag kesar, that is another spice. Okay, so here is our Maharashtrian masale bath, and I have chopped some salad to go with it. You can add some homemade curds, sugar, salt, roasted peanut powder and some coriander to this to make our koshimbir, that is raita. Okay, and this is our Mexican burger. So if you people have any questions, you can ask them. So if you all have any questions, you can ask. Oh, thank you, thank you. Yeah, the Mexican burger, actually, please adjust the spice levels or anything as per your taste. So, thank you all the people, those who are giving me such lovely compliments. And please excuse me if I have made any mistake. This is a new experience for me, going live. And thank you Cookpad and all the team members who chose me to go live today. I had actually refused because I was a little nervous. Yeah, and it's very hot right now over here. Due to the heavy rains, we have to close our windows also. So, if any questions are there, you can ask me. But I think I'm already clear. And the recipe of Maharashtrian Masale Bath is already on the Cookpad, my profile, and I'll be posting the Mexican burger maybe by tonight or by tomorrow. I'll try to complete it because the photography is already done. Okay, so can I take leave now? And thanks Poonam, Avni, there are few names which I know, Roli, and today itself I got a message that my recipes has been chosen for the Indian Kitchen book also. Thanks for that also. Actually, I was really hoping for those books more than anything else. Okay. So once again, we can just take a look at the recipes, I mean the dishes. So here is a Maharashtrian Masale Bath with a garnishing of fresh coconut, coriander leaves and some homemade ghee. Coconut and ghee is very important. Then here you have this salad to which you can add homemade curds, or you can just have it like that and make a raita or a koshimbir as we call it out of it. And here is your Mexican burger. See, the guacamole and the salsa, everything you can adjust, you know, more or less as you like it. But I would advise that please add a lot of salsa and guacamole, because this patty otherwise can taste, this patty can taste really dry, okay? Thank you Jasmine ji, thank you Sneha, Prima, Karan, Sushma, Suman, thanks everyone. Chanchal, Neerja, Kiran, Luna. So now I'll take your leave. Yeah. Bye, and hope you all enjoyed watching me live. Thank you very much for giving me your precious time. And thanks once again to the entire team of Cookpad for choosing me to go live today. Thanks, and bye from Mumbai, Maharashtra.